In this video, I want to show you how to simulate this electric circuit. You will not need to install any software because it is possible to simulate everything online. With this circuit, it is possible to turn on and off a DC motor with a delay that we can program. Let's simulate everything online. In the browser, we search the following website, Tinkercad.com. After we create an account and log in, this page appears. Here we have the options 3D designs, circuits and lessons. We choose circuits, and as you can see, I have a project done, but let's create a new one. After creating a new project, it will be possible to visualize and select a good amount of components. We have a tab for the basic components, one tab for all components, and one for the starters. In this last tab we can find a number of circuits ready to be simulated. To begin with, I will introduce you to the brain of our project, an Arduino Uno. The Arduino Uno is a microcontroller on a board with all components needed to perform prototyping. It can be easily programmed through a software called Arduino IDE. It has 13 digital pins that work with 0 volts and 5 volts. The 0 pin and the pin number 1 can be used for TX and RX communications. It has 6 analog inputs that receive 0 to 5 volts. Some digital pins can also work with PWM signals. They can be identified with the ripple symbol. And for power it has VIN to grounds, 5 volts, 3.3 volts. We still have a pin to reset, IRF, AREF, and another ground. We can use the search bar to find our DC motor and drag them to the mounting zone. I use the 13 digital pin as an output of 5 volts and connect them to the red terminal of the motor. We give the color red, you can choose any one, to the wires and connect the black terminal of the motor to the ground of the Arduino. This is not the final circuit, there is something wrong here, but I will explain you later. So, the electric current comes out of the pin, passing in the motor making them spin, and goes to the ground. Here on the top we have the barcode editor. Clicking on it, appears below a window where we can edit the code. We can program the Arduino through blocks, but I personally prefer program them in the traditional way. So I will close the programming blocks window and program them like we use in IDE. To send the code to the Arduino, we use a USB cable as it appears in the image. But this is just a simulation. To program the Arduino, our code must have two parts, void setup and void loop. Void setup is the part of the code where we make the settings for what each Arduino pin does, and it only runs or executes once. When we write pin mode 13 output, it means that we set the pin 13 of the Arduino as output. We must respect typography so the code can be compiled without errors, and all parentheses and commas have a purpose. Void loop is the part of the code that will run repeatedly. The code is always read from the top to the bottom, starting by executing the void setup once and running the void loop continuously. When we write digital write 13 high, this is a function that gives order to set the voltage level at 5 volts on the pin 13. It could be another digital pin of our choice. Delay 1000. This is a function that creates a delay, 1 second or 1000 milliseconds, but could be the time that you want. Digital write 13 low is the same as the function of line 9 But in this case, low means that the voltage level will be zero. In other words, the motor will stop. Again, we have a delay of 1 second, and the cycle repeats. Therefore, this code causes the motor to power on for 1 second and power off for 1 second repeatedly. Now, click on Upload and Run. Soon after, the simulation begins and we can actually see the gear moving. It is even possible to see the speed of rotation of the motor. Just as we wanted, the motor runs for 1 second and stops for 1 second and repeats again and again. But the truth is that this circuit can damage the Arduino. Let me explain. I will stop the simulation, look for a multimeter and set to measure amperage. To carry out this measurement, we need to connect the motor in series with the multimeter. Start the simulation, and as you can see, the current has a maximum value of 43.5 milliamps. The Arduino can only supply 50 milliamps by the digital pins, so the current value is at the limit. If we put some load on the motor, this current level will rise. Often it will exceed the 50 milliamps and damage the Arduino, so I'm going to carry out the assembly of the circuit to be able to power on and power off the motor without risk of damaging the Arduino. This video is becoming very long, so I will show you the other circuits in another video. Hasta.